rock the beaches. I am tumbling down with the roots of trees. Embrace you, I do fall upon my knees and ask you how you can just sit there and be rock of ages. I am crumbling now in an avalanche. I'm reaching for the rock of ages, rock of ages.
Talk just a little bit about the experience of signing to a major label and what that experience was like for you.
Oh, goodness. That was the kind of thing where we signed to Slash, which is one of the original independent labels, but Slash had a relationship of like a distribution or all that with Warner Brothers in terms of the U.S. And
they had very cool bands like Del Fuego's. Do you
Slash had Del Fuego's, had X, had Lobos. You know, yeah, Dream Syndicate. You know, we were quite very very grateful to be among those bands. You know, you had a little bit of extra muscle in terms of getting the word out about the album. I think there was a little more. Synergy in those days, when you had, you know, you had a record, you had some radio airplay, you had some print magazines, and it all kind of worked hand in glove, you know, on the best of days. That's what you would, you know, aspire to anyway.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Lie to
moved to Los Angeles in like 83, and a group in Stockton. Stockton is in Northern California, Central Valley. And shortly before I left Stockton to begin a period going to film school in LA, I met a couple of guys, Jeff Clark and Kelly Foley, and they had a band called Torn Boys in Stockton. And myself and my good friend Jan, we had our own little band, and he told me about these guys, Torn Boys, you know. And as it turned out, we hit it off. My friend Jan was involved with a tragic accident that year. He's a young guy, but he was responsible for introducing me to Jeff and to Kelly. And so I began to play with those guys, you know. And that was kind of my introduction to to the band life in some way. You know, it definitely it whet my appetite for more of it, you know. But I was so young, I couldn't get into a lot of the clubs, you know. I was 19 at that time. And so Jeff, he came down with me to LA, and we began putting together our own band, Shiva Burlesque. Kind of we had our own sort of unique influences, you know. And that band kind of lasted for about maybe 7 years or so, the whole thing, you know.
Who would you say were your influences for that band?
Well, I suppose I would trace my influences firstly to the stuff that was on AM and FM radio in the 70s and, you know, late 70s, early 80s. But the things that kind of really stuck out to me, you know, were Bowie, you know, firstly Queen, but then, you know, Johnny Cash, though. You know, how do you reconcile all of that, you know? I don't know. Somehow it makes sense. It makes sense to me. It makes sense to Rhett Miller as well. You know?
Absolutely.
Johnny Cash and Bowie, those two polarities, you know? I was, and through Bowie, I discovered all of these other characters like Fripp and Iggy Pop and Robert Fripp and even people like Bertolt Brecht, you know, because of an album that he put out from a BBC production of Brecht's Ball. Great songs on that. And when I met Jeff Clark, those guys were covering Mack the Knife, you know, they were covering songs by Television, and then they had a Mack the Knife cover, you know. It's like, wow. And then he consequently turned me on to, like, you know, John Cale and Patti Smith and all this other stuff, you know. And so, you know, it's, I think that's the part that I still love about this, is the archaeology of it all, you know, digging around and finding, used to be digging through the bins, you know, mm-hmm. and finding that weird looking album or that band that just sounded like they would be great. And, you know, we kind of aspire to be that kind of a weird band that, you know, I don't know that our aspirations necessarily were to, you know, crack top 40 radio, but wouldn't it be great to be like one of those weird bands that, you know, somebody picks up and says, what is this? Our first album, the Shiva Burlesque album, I remember it being in the bins at Tower Records on Sunset in Hollywood, and I picked up a copy and I bought it and I gave it to Weird Al Yankovic, who was going through the bins himself. And I said, "Mr. Yankovic, can I give you a copy of our band's debut album?" And he said, "Sure."
Sleepy rhythms
numb and I was feeling tired, crying out in a wordless howl, screeching off to the underground, certain of this one thing, certain of this one thing. Words.